In today's video, I'll be showing you how to make a rules channel on Discord. Start by going to your Discord server. Right-click on the left panel and create a new channel. Make it a text channel and name it Rules. Create channel. Drag the rules channel into the position you want it. Hover over the channel and click the gear icon. Go to permissions. Expand the advanced permissions. Make sure the everyone role is selected. Enable the view channel and read message history option. Disable the ability to send messages. Save changes. Switch to the integrations tab. Click create webhook. Here you need to set the name and image that will be used for the message. Change the name to your server name. Click on the Discord logo on the side. Select a profile picture. We recommend using the server picture. Apply your settings. Make sure the channel is set to the rules channel. Save changes. Copy the webhook URL, then close. Head to the Disco Hook website. Click the clear all button. Confirm. Paste the copied webhook URL into the provided box. Select Add Embed. The first embed can be used for a banner image or your first rule. Expand the embed. Open the image section. Pasting an image web address into the URL section will add the image to your message. The easiest way to get an image URL is to share the image in a hidden private channel in your server or send it via DM. Right-click on the image and choose Copy Link. Head back to Disco Hook and paste in the URL. If you're not using a header image, then this embed can be used for your first rule. Alternatively, add a new embed. Open the embed. Expand the body. Enter your first rule into the title section. Clarify the rule in the description section. The title can be set to a clickable link by entering a web address in the URL section. Click the colored box. Use the RGB slider on the side to choose a color profile. Click and drag on the toning panel to select the color of your embed. If you want to use the same color for other rules, then highlight and copy their color code. Click Add Embed and repeat the process for all rules. Each message can only have 10 embeds. If you have more than 10 rules, then you can add another message. You can also add custom user, role, channel, and emojis to your message. To do this, you will need to use the appropriate command shown on screen. Each command will require you to use the required ID. You can find the IDs by enabling developer mode on Discord. Open the user settings. Switch to the Advanced tab. Enable the developer mode and close. A channel ID can be found by right-clicking on the channel and choosing to Copy ID. You can copy a user ID by right-clicking on their name in the members panel or from a channel message. To copy a role ID, you will need to open the server settings. Go to Roles. Right-click on the role and copy ID. The channel, role, and user ID will need to replace the text in the command. To get a custom emoji ID, you will need to add the emoji to a blank message. Go back and type a backslash before the emoji. This is the button above your Enter key. Send the message and the emoji ID will be shown, allowing you to copy and paste it into your embed. Examples of what the finished command should look like will be on screen. A standard emoji can be added by either copying, pasting it, or by pressing the Windows key and semicolon on your keyboard. This will open the emoji window. Once you have finished creating your rules message, click the Send button at the top. Head back to Discord and your rules channel will now be set up. If you need to edit the message, then click on the three dots and choose to Copy Message Link. Go back to Disco Hook and paste the URL into the message link section. Make the changes to your message. Press Edit. Your Discord rules message will now be updated. When creating your embed, a custom URL is generated. If you plan on making changes to the message at any point, then we recommend bookmarking the page or saving the link. This will prevent you from having to re-enter all the rules or message info again. However, you will need to input the webhook and message link again.